Pasnur, working as an assistant professor in civil department from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today's class we are going to discuss on arches and its types. These are the learning outcomes. At the end of this session, students will be able to identify the different types of the arches and their suitability. This is a arch, so there are technical terms. The intradurs is the inner curve of the arc, whereas the extradurs is the outer curve of the arc. This is the topmost portion, which is called as the crown, that is the highest point, highest part of the extradurs. The key, it is called as the portion of below the crown. The rise, the vertical height of the crown arch, is called as the rise. So these are the abutments which are provided at the end of the arch, the supports given to the arch, and the piers are also provided, which is the intermediate support which is provided in the series of the arches, and the arcade is known as the series of the arches in continuation, and this is the haunch, which is the half portion from the springing line. This is called as the haunch. The springer, that is the wedge shaped unit, which may be of an brick or the stone, which is placed above the springing line, is called as the springer. So an arch is generally a structural member which is used in the building to build across the openings of the doors, windows or the cupboards to withstand the load coming over the opening. So the support to the superimposed loads can be given by providing an arch or a lintel. So the arch supports the loads by the arch action, whereas the lintel supports the load by it acts as the beam which transfers the load vertically to the supporting walls. So the arches, it is a mechanical arrangement of the bricks or the stones, that is the wedge shaped units. These are placed around a curved line which mutually support each other. This is the classification of the arches, which is based on the shape of the arch. Second is the number of the centers of the arch, and third we have the workmanship and the material used. So out of this we will be discussing on the shape. These are the arches based on the shape. So first we have the flat arch, second is the segmental arch, third semicircular arch, fourth is the horseshoe arch, next pointed arch, Venetian arch, Florentine arch, and the relieving arch. This is the flat arch. So from the sketch itself we can know that this is the extradurs, the outer part of the curve, and this is the intradurs. It is perfectly flat and horizontal. So a skew back is provided, which is at an angle of 60 degrees. So it is an angle of 60 degrees. So the depth of the arch, it is around 3 to 4 courses. A course is nothing but where the bricks are placed in a single course. It is called as the course. So the depth will be around 3 to 4 courses. And the angle is 60 degrees. So this is used for the light loads. It is not strong enough. So for that the span is limited. It is around 1.5 meters. And if at all you want to use it for the more span, the steel reinforcement has to be provided. Next we have the segmental arch. Here you can see in the sketch that the extradurs, it is a the shape of the arch itself is segmental in shape, and here you can see that the center of the arch is below the springing line. This is the springing line which joins the springing points at the either ends. So this is the springing line. Here you can see that this is the voices is the wedge shaped units, which may be of brick and the stone, and the skew backs are provided. The pier, it is a intermediate support given to the arch. So in this type of the arch, the depth of the arch is around 20 centimeter, 30 centimeter and so on. It is used for the various types of the openings, which may be of different sizes. It is used in the buildings. The semicircular arch. From the name itself, you can say that the shape of the arch is semicircular shape. But here you can see that the center of the arch lies on the springing line itself. So that the center of the arch, so that we get a semicircular shape. Next we have the horseshoe arch. So the horseshoe arch, it is the shape of the arch is horseshoe, and it has a more deeper curve of a semicircular shape, and it is used for the architectural purpose due to the shape of the arch. So this is the crown placed and this is the key. These are the abutments. These are the springing line. It is a line, imaginary line joining the curve of the arch. These are the springing. Above that we have the springer, where we place the wedge shaped unit, which may be stone or the brick. Next we have the pointed arch. In the sketch itself, you can see that this is a pointed arch. That means the two arcs are joined to each other, where at the intersection you get a pointed shape, that is called as the pointed arch. So it is a two-centered arch, and due to the shape of this arch, it is called as the Gothic arch also, and it is used for the architectural purpose. Next we have the Venetian arch. So this is one form of the pointed arch also. Here you can see that the crown, it is the depth of the crown is more. It is more, and also it is used for the architectural purpose due to its look. And here the arch is drawn using the four centers arch, that is the inner circle, it can be drawn by using the two centers, whereas the outer arc can be drawn by using two centers. So total you will be needing four centers for drawing this arch. Next we have the Florentine arch. This is particular arch, you can see that it is similar to the Venetian arch, except that the inner curve of the arch is a perfect semicircle. So this semicircle is drawn by using a single center. To draw this semicircle, we need a single center point, and the outer line, it is a curve. So total for this arch, three centers are needed. This is used for the architectural purposes. Next we have the relieving arch. So this type of the arch is constructed. Here you can see that this is the flat arch, and below that you have a wooden lintel also. So the relieving arch itself can be provided above the flat arch or the wooden lintel to support the load coming over that arch. So this wooden lintel, it can be even replaced also without disturbing the stability of the structure, and this type of arch is provided to withstand the load coming over this arch. So here you can select the correct answer for the below question. So identify the type of the arch given below. So here is a sketch given to this, as here is an angle given as the skew back. You can see that the extraders and the intraders, they are perfectly horizontal, but a skew back angle is given as 60 degrees, and the center, you can see that the center is much below. So here are the options as which type of arch it is from the sketch itself you have to identify with. First we have the flat arch, second the Venetian arch, the horseshoe arch and the living arch. So think for a while and answer it. So flat arch is the correct answer for that, where we have the center below and it is perfectly flat in shape. The one which we had discussed before, the sketch is similar to that. These are the references which I have. Thank you.